Don't be fucking with about that shit. That's a joke. We got y'all some low down niggas, you know, that's a leave that man alone, go eat the wrist. You know, my man come with a bone. That's all right. That's it. We know you what? Okay. That nigga said he like crack, that's it. I don't know what kind of crack you like, but any time for a man is bad. What the fuck kind of crack it is, it's just bad. It's, I don't know what kind of crack, nigga ain't never supposed to like crack, nigga. Ever in his life. That's what he said, that's what you heard, too, I like crack, you know. Nigga, I don't like crack. I don't look at me, I'm my own fuck with crack, nigga. I don't fuck with crack. No, I don't fuck with crack. Leave the motherfucker alone until you listen to the show, man. I'm shit. He gonna give you your own pussy. Leave the nigga alone. Not that. The rest of the nigga chest, too. Shit. Oh, damn. Nah, man, we good. Let's go. Nah, we good, man. We good. We know. I got you. After you do, you know, but then you have my man Tom Capone funny and shit up here talk about he got hot. And I remember when he was running out that door with that shit on because he was late for a show. And I didn't know it was him. We used to live in the same noble neighborhood. I said, Tom Capone, I just seen your mom running out the house. That's who I thought it was because I don't want to say Tom Capone on shit like that. And that's what he said. He smoked dope. That's what it is. He was hot. If you get high, shit like that happen. He go high. That would happen when you smoke dope. High. Smoke dope. No, nigga, I don't smoke dope, nigga. I smoke reefer. That's the fuck I smoke. Then you young, you smoke dope. You smoke dope, I smoke reefer. I smoke reefer. Now, I'm the fuck I smoke. I don't smoke no dope, nigga. I smoke reefer. All right. That's what the fuck I smoke reefer. All right, swag and surfing swag. I'm going to tell you. Let me do these jokes. No, let me tell you. No, dude, I'm gonna tell you, we just want, thank you. You know me, you know what I do, so let me just do the rest of these jokes and we really happy. And now what it is, you know, I don't smoke dope, I smoke reefer. Oh, nigga, I smoke reefer. That nigga smoke reefer, right there, that nigga smoke reefer, that was the fuck, smoke reefer. Young nigga smoke dope. I smoke the shit when you used to come in a vanilla envelope. You remember shit used to come in a vanilla envelope? They got a tied envelope, that was the fuck I smoke reefer. And she just coming up over like a tide envelope. I remember one night I got so high, I left the wrong envelope at church on a Sunday morning. Then the pastor gonna call me and tell me, I need to holler at you about something. I say, no, nigga, I need to holler at you about something. 10% of that wreath is yours, but the rest of that wreath is mine. Now, where is my motherfucking wreath? No motherfucking dope, nigga. I smoke a reefer. Dope to have your ass buck naked on 85 talking about, my baby needs some shoes for the squirrel to wear. I don't smoke that shit. You don't even know what the fuck dope do to you. Never smoke dope in the hand, you motherfucking high, and you try to unhigh yourself. Nigga, you ever tried to unhigh yourself and get a high at your body? Who get a high at my body? That's why I smoke reefer. Young nigga like that smoke dope. I remember one night, I got so high with a nephew, this nigga smoked dope, this nigga had me so high, I left my house to go home. What the fuck you gave me? What the fuck you gave me that nigga got to get out of his house? Cause I'm getting the fuck up out of my house, I got to go the fuck home. I don't know what the fuck y'all gave me, but I ain't supposed to be here. Now I come back 20 minutes later, who are y'all niggas in my house getting high? Is that dope, nigga? You don't know what dope do to you, nigga? Nigga, I'm mad dope. I went in the bathroom to wipe the high off my face. You ever try to wipe the high off? Why is the high up in my leg? The high you just get in my left leg. You just had the high just fuck with one part of your body. What the fuck is... Got a hell of a headliner for tonight. Y'all ready for your headliner? Say hell yeah. Headliner Comedy States, a good friend of mine. You'll see him on Def Comedy Jam. You'll see him on BET Comicville. He won Who's Got Joke the second season, straight up out of Atlanta, Georgia. Put your hands together for a good friend of mine, Mr. Lab Lord.
I'm feeling good. I'm having fun. This is the way. What's up, how y'all doing? Y'all doing alright? Nigga, turn that up. Don't turn that off here. It's grown people shit right here. Take your girl, it's the purpose of the song. Oh, I want you closer. You look like a mother off of a poster. Listen to the whole goddamn song. This could be the best night of your life. Nigga, that's a whole different type of fucking right there, I gotta tell you. Hey, how y'all doing? Y'all doing all right? Y'all show some love to Tom Brown one more time for Nick Lewis doing that thing. All right, before we get into this, into some shit, you know, as a comedian, when you get on stage, you just get to talk about what the fuck you want to. So before I get to the jokes, there's some shit I want to talk about before we get to the goddamn jokes. First, where the parents at? Make some noise. Everybody got some kids. Make some noise. Where y'all at? Yeah. All right. Stop. All right. Now, people with kids. I mean, y'all got teenagers. Make some noise. Clap. People with teenagers. All right. One more question, then we're going to get into it. People with little kids. Clap. Make some noise. People with little kids. All right. Now, people with little kids and people without kids, you ain't going to feel the shit we get ready to talk about. All right? We're getting ready to talk about this whole crypto dollar shit. With all my ass. Nigga. This is what we get ready to talk about, this crypto dollar shit. Listen, first of all, usually mega preachers, you know, these big church niggas, I be on their ass. But in this one right here, I got to have this nigga back right here, cuz. If you got a 16-year-old child and you tell them not to do some shit, then they come home at 2 o'clock in the morning and did what the fuck you told them not to do, you supposed to choke them. That's the goddamn proper response. Anybody else feel the same goddamn way? See, because if you got a teenager, y'all know, goddamn, a teenager's fucking retarded any goddamn way. A teenager got to be the dumbest motherfucker on earth. I don't care how smart you think your teenager is, they dumb as shit right there. They might got book sense, but teenagers don't have goddamn common sense that goddamn all. Because I know I ain't the only person in here to have one of these conversations right here. Clap if you feel me on this. Why the fuck I got to tell you to clean up? This your goddamn house too, goddamn. Why the fuck I got to tell you to clean out the goddamn dishwasher? Didn't you wash these motherfuckers? Who is this little bitch keep calling my house all goddamn time? Maybe that's just me right there. Nigga, I'm just saying. And you know, they like, well, that's abuse because he choked her. Listen, he's supposed to choke her. Every child, at some point in time, is the natural progression will raise up against their parents. That's just it. I did it, you did it, your mama did it, your grandmama did it. Every child at some point in time raises up against their parent. But it is your job as the parent, when they raise up, to fucking put them back in their fucking place. That is your goddamn job. That's why some of y'all kids don't know how to act now, because you ain't putting these niggas in their fucking place. Let me tell you, and you got to do whatever the fuck it takes to put them in their goddamn place. And that includes choking a motherfucker. I don't know if you know this or not, but if you start choking a motherfucker, you have their full attention. Because they never get your attention like the oxygen leaving your goddamn lungs and not being goddamn replaced. I promise you that little bit right there. Fucking kidding me? These motherfuckers, see, this some of y'all fucking parents, y'all some weak motherfuckers. Y'all just let these kids do the fuck they want to. Talking to them and shit. Rationalizing. Fuck that. Nigga, I turned out great. My mother ain't rationalized with shit. My mother, we was a dictatorship. You did what the fuck she told you to do, when she told you to do it. Cause she, my mama's rule was, goddamn it, don't, motherfuckers who don't pay no bills don't got no goddamn say-so. If you don't pay them that's goddamn light bill, this phone bill, this goddamn mortgage, then you do the fuck I tell you to do. I'm like, well, mama, this is my house too. She's like, no, the fuck it ain't. nigga, you broke. You a goddamn squatter, nigga. That was my fucking nigga. My mama was fucking nigga. Saturday. Let me give you, tell you how fucking low down my mama was. Fucking nigga, Saturday, that was my mama clean up day. Before she started cleaning up, she goddamn laid the law down. She's like, hey, I'm finna start cleaning up, and if your shit is on the floor, it's going in the trash. Okay, so I ain't the only mama who mama say this shit right now. See, that's some evil shit, goddamn. Let's see, this when I had my little raise-up moment with my mama, goddamn. See, Saturday she was cleaning up and shit, nigga, goddamn. You know, I had a little job, so I'm buying some of my own clothes. And I came in the kitchen, my god. Now, I don't know if you know anything about Jordans, but I had a pair of new Jordans. Jordans brand new, like $160, $180. I look in the trash, my Jordans in the trash, with some eggs on top of it. You. She said, what you say? I said, I got some issues. You know you can't cuss on a black mama and live. And every child raised up against their goddamn mama. And we do not fucking have niggas. Another story. Nigga, you know, like, don't break my mama rules. Her shit was, I don't give a fuck who you are. If you in my house, my rules apply to you. So I had one of my friends, we 8 years old. This nigga come to spend the night. His mama to send him over there with a towel and his own wash rag. Now the rule in our house is once you fucking wash your face, you put your wash rag on the little fucking hanging rack right there. So this nigga to wash his face and left his rag on the goddamn counter. We wake up Saturday morning, clean up day, she is cleaning the toilet with this nigga rag. I mean, cleaning it out. I like, mama, that's his rag. My mom's, I don't give a fuck. She, he know the goddamn rule. Put the fucking rag on this goddamn shelf, you little fucking no home trying to have the motherfucker, and threw this nigga his rag. That nigga looked at the rag, looked at me, I looked back at him, looked down at the rag, I said, nigga, better go home and wash your face. But she ain't gonna give you another rag. You ask for another rag, what's the first thing she gonna say? Nigga, did your mama see you over here with one? Nigga, my mama was fucking evil as shit. Like, you know how some of y'all thread your kids with them little regular threads. I'm gonna beat your ass. Nigga, that didn't hold enough weight for my mama. My mama believed in striking fear in your ass. Man, one time, we went to a restaurant. Me and my sister, you know, you go to a restaurant with a black mom, you gotta get a speech. Like, listen, don't be up in these people's shit like you ain't got no home training. You sit down, eat, we're gonna get the fuck on about our business. Me and my sister, we 7 and 9. I don't give a fuck about that, nigga. This fucking, we finna fall till we fall in this bitch. You know what I mean? We get in the restaurant, we crawling up under the tables. I'm bouncing the fucking rolls off my sister's forehead. My mama leaned over, said, I'll fucking kill you. You hear me? I kill you right in this fucking restaurant. I'll chop you the fuck up, put you in this goddamn salad, and eat you the fuck up. Nobody ever know you was in this motherfucker with me. Do you hear me? And we was scared. Like, mama, you a fucking eat us? She like, the fuck up? Like, this bitch is crazy. That's what I got to know right there. Alright, start it off.
When you start to speak Spanish, every sexually, but the energy after I'm done, you still tell me who you are. You want a second try, you want me on the front, back, left, and the right. Baby, I will guarantee you to give you everything your body's missing.
Nigga, I'm ready, goddamn. I'm goddamn good. Hey, I had a good time. Y'all enjoyed it on Saturday evening. I got DVDs for sale. Come get yourself a DVD. Even if you don't want a DVD, just come say what's up. Other than that, my name is Lad Love. I'm out of here.
Put your hands together for Lad Love.
One more time for Lad Love.
Damn.
If you go home and you try that move and you hurt yourself, the club is not responsible. So we quickly hand you up a lab love up at the BBC tonight. We got DVDs on sale at the back. My name is Nick Woods. If you got a birthday, talk to the people at the club. We do this every Wednesday night. Next Wednesday, we got my man Jay Smooth. I don't know if y'all remember from Club Banging. Jay Smooth and Ike and Tina Turner. We got it then next Wednesday. So definitely be here. Go to the bar. The club is not over. Eat some food. My name is Nick Woods. See y'all again next week. All right, peace.